This is fantastic. You know, it's such a great opportunity to talk to a filmmaker that I've always admired so much. I always said when I grew up, I wanted to be you. And now, even today, I say when I grow up, I want to be you. Because I want to keep that energy and that passion for movies. And you just shoot back to back to back, you know, and you've got such incredible taste that it just allows you to go from one film to another.
Yeah, the plan is that there is no plan.
Yeah, exactly. And you mentioned when we were talking before we sat down here about George Orwell and all that.
Sure.
And that reminded me of your really famous award-winning 1984.
Oh, Steve.
The real, yeah, the
Jobs.
The Apple commercial with the girl with the hammer.
Yeah.
And how that, first of all, revolutionized what a TV advert could be.
Sure.
But it's just a beautiful little, short film.
You know, the courage of an agency, the Shire Day, were brand new, hadn't got an account. They had this account.
Mm-hmm.
They came to me. I was very, very big as a commercial maker, and they gave me one sheet saying, look, this is the thing. I said, well, Apple, this is the Beatles. And he said, no, not the Beatles. This is a guy called Steve Jobs. And see, Mike, he says, computers. I said, for what? Household computers, what, to write the shopping list? What are you talking about? How wrong I am. And I said, you know, how much does it cost? He said, $2.50. I said, are you kidding? It's too expensive. But I like it. It's fun because you never show the product.
Yeah.
And all you at the end say is, we're going to show you, relying on the fact that people know what 1984 was.
Yeah.
Surprising how many people know what it was.
It wouldn't work today because too many science fiction fans only know their science fiction from movies and television and their pop culture references, video games, and so on.
Yeah.
They don't know it from the literary roots.
Well, they don't read. We are today's novelists, if you like, because the evolution of the film, in effect, is a book.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
And they vary in how good they are to how ordinary they are. That's the way it goes in literature as well.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm hoping that we are replacing the book, but it's a lazy way of getting information because you're sitting there, you're not having to do this, smell the page and look at the cover.
Yeah.
You're just being fed information.
Yeah.
Is that good or bad? I don't know.
Well, you have literary roots to a number of your films, like Blade Runner comes from a Philip K. Dick novel.
Yeah.
Do Androids Dream of Electric Sheep, which most people don't remember.
Yeah, the book is very 19 stories in the first 20 pages.
Yeah, exactly. And he was all over the place.
And one of the problems is you've got to select that central story, which Hampton did, Fanshawe did.
Yeah.
And then off that, I met Dick, who said, read that I said, off the side, and you got to be careful what you say. I said, geez, I couldn't get through the book. He was furious. So to make amends, I invite him to EEG one morning, Doug Trumbull's place, saying, listen, come and look at a couple of shots. So I showed him the opening of the movie.
Yeah.
And he was absolutely blown away.
Good.
And
good.
Was quelled.
I'm glad you made amends. I'm glad you made amends. And then, in my mind, the what completed that package, that experiential package for me as an audience member, was just your pure cinema layered on top of that.
Mm-hmm.
You put us into that world. You felt the grit, you felt the rain in the streets, you felt the crowding.
You know, all that comes from just life and living, because I'd done a lot of commercials before any film, a lot. And in that time, it would take me to Hong Kong prior to the first skyscraper ever being built in Hong Kong.
Yeah.
So I was working in the harbor on junks. In the harbor would be 1,000 junks.
Yeah.
And the Bank of Hong Kong was just about to be built. So Hong Kong was a massive medieval situation. It was unbelievably stunning.
Yeah.
And they just discovered polystyrene, so everything went out the window. So the harbor was a floating mass of polystyrene.
Yeah.
And it was the future. That was dystopia.
Yeah.